Quiet nights of quiet stars, quiet chords from Bob's guitar, floating on the silence that surrounds us.
Hi folks, this is Bob Piorun, and this is my show, Musically Speaking, where I'm documenting the music of Auburn and the whole central New York area. And today I have a very special guest and a good friend. What was your name again?
Hi.
Oh, no. Luis Molina.
Hi.
Luis Molina.
Thank you for having me.
And we're going to talk a little bit about his musical abilities and his other. He's a great performer. So, Luis, let's start with this, because I don't know some of these things. So, where were you born?
I was born in Queens.
Where is
in
it?
In Astoria, Queens, you know, one of the five boroughs.
Yeah.
And I was born, I'm the first generation. My parents were both born in Cuba, and then they met in Brooklyn. And, you know, when I was born in Queens in Astoria.
Okay, so how long did you stay there?
Oh, since I was 20. And then ever since I had moved, I moved first to Auburn in 1991. And since then it's been, you know, just trying to perform, trying to make it, you know, the
right.
living. And
yeah. So I'm thinking you started as a dancer. Was that the first thing you wanted to be?
When I was a kid and graduating from high school, that was the thing. You know, I had learned how to, you know, hip hop battles. That's how I came up.
Yeah.
Really, yeah.
On the street corners.
Yeah, on the kid. Yeah. You know, the kids were trying to, you know, get that move.
Oh,
and
I see.
So I was the pop locker of the group. And yeah. When I was a kid, I took up roller skating. And when we'd get tired, we'd kick off the skates and start dancing in the center. I loved it. I took a liking to it, loved to it, and tried to perform as often as I could. You know, when we had a break, and then. I moved up. I started studying ballet and
you got into it doing some street things.
Yes,
and then you
yes.
got you did some formal studying.
Yes, and then I did formal studying fine arts techniques, ballet and modern dancing, which was really a wonderful, you know, some people may call it contemporary or or lyrical or something like that. And then, you know, I was also doing tap. And, you know, so ballet, tap, jazz, of course, all the cool, great musical theater styles.
Did you have some idea of doing that as a living? You wanted to get it. You're in New York. Did you want to get into
around here locally, for instance, some of my background in dance, I was Captain Hook for the Syracuse City Ballet. Twice, you know, 20 years later, they invited me after the first time. And so it was quite an honor to do that. Mm-hmm. And so all of those years of studying dance and knowing how to do it made, you know, kind of got me there. And I think that was the pinnacle of, you know, Syracuse City. It was a wonderful experience and their audiences are wonderful. I was booed once. And I was supposed to be booed. I was trying to do my best to get booed, and finally, you know, one of the performances I was booed.
Because he's a mean guy.
Yeah, because I'm the mean guy, you know, with the hook, and you know, so that was it. Was a great, you know, part of my career in dance.
Was there singing in that?
No, okay. That was strictly a classical.
So,
you know,
just, so you started off as a dancer. So when did you realize that you could sing someplace?
Or
you just came up singing?
You know, I just came up singing at first. And, you know, it's pretty memorable, this moment where I auditioned for my high school. He was the director of one of the shows I was in. And I didn't really sing for anyone outside of my family. So some of my friends knew I could sing and I could really sing.
Right.
And then my family knew I could really sing. My sisters and I always would try and get every, you know, duet and every song down. And then finally I sang real for a guy on a piano saying, "You can do this, Luis. You can
do
this."
You remember what you sang?
And I do not. I don't. It was sort of, I don't know.
One of those high school shows.
Yeah, it was probably just an like
Greece or something.
Yeah, and I was just going, and he said, "What?" You know, I was blown away that I had the confidence then, and I hadn't had it before to really do it in front of anyone else like that.
Right.
And then coming up here, you know, I was with Theater 90s, and I had done, you know, I had done all of these shows around here, and then directed high school musicals, and knew I had this passion in me, but I really wasn't out there.
Mm-hmm.
4 years ago, 4 or 5 years ago, I started a band, a rock band. I love it, but sometimes rock music doesn't really get me where I am. And
right.
I think that even though it's lovely, there's so many types of music that I just love and enjoy.
That leads me to this. I'm supposing you grew up with your Cuban parents. They were speaking Spanish.
Yes. Oh,
did
yeah.
they speak? Yeah. That was the main language in
Yeah.
Your
well,
home,
yes. So coming up, obviously, well, my folks were in America for so long, especially after the reign of, you know, Batista was overthrown and the
right.
communism set into Cuba. So they were in New York. They opened a couple of very successful businesses, and you know, all of these different families were all Spanish speaking.
I see.
My sisters were English speakers.
Right.
You know, they were whatever. When they came up, almost 8 years my senior at this point, they were all speaking to me in English while our parents were speaking to us in Spanish.
So you, basically, yeah. it was bilingual.
Yes.
Because that leads me to the fact of the first song we're going to do.
Oh, okay.
And I'll give a little. Actually, this was a Mexican songwriter, and it's interesting because this song, which a lot of people know, it's become a standard. Besame Mucho, Kiss Me Much, was written by a 15-year-old Mexican girl in 1940. See, I didn't know they had kissing back then.
No,
I guess
no, that's a new invention.
But anyways, her name was Consuelo Velasquez.
Oh, wow.
And that, you know, sounds like, you know, like John
like my
Smith.
Godmother or something.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, like everybody's named Consuelo.
Yeah, right. So we're going to do this, and you are going to sing it in Spanish.
Oh, yes, of course, yeah. Oh. Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Bésame, bésame mucho, que tengo miedo a perderte. Perderte después. Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Bésame, bésame mucho. Que tengo miedo a perderte, perderte después. Quiero mirarme en tus ojos, verte junto a mí. Piensa que tal vez mañana yo ya estaré lejos, muy lejos de ti. Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Bésame, bésame mucho, que tengo miedo a perderte. Perderte después, que tengo miedo a perderte, perderte después.
Okay, So there's a little thing from 1940, a Spanish classic, Besame Mucho. Mm. So let's get on to another subject. Of course, we met about a year or so ago, and we've been working regularly together, and I guess we could drop the name of the place we play regularly. That's Osteria Salina every Tuesday night, and hopefully we'll be there when this is airing. I don't see any reason why we wouldn't, hopefully. But we met, and we've been working regularly. And recently, I found out your daughter, and you can explain this, had some medical problems. And why don't we talk about that subject, your daughter, what transpired, and what's being done to help her?
Yes, thank you. She is a wonderful 8-year-old. She was recently, we were recently told that she's been diagnosed with type 1 diabetes, and it's pretty intense just having that in one's life. There's a lot of monitoring of blood glucose just to be sure that she's not crashing or flying high in DKA. You know, that's been our primary focus in the family, trying to understand the condition and living through it, working with it and dealing with it, and just learning its ways. And, you know, every day is very unique and every day can be very different. So, you know, it's not the it's not like type 2. Type 2 is something that one can typically change with proper diet, proper exercise, and, you know, just health conscious type of thing. But this is a condition that there is no changing. There are some stem cell studies that are coming out, but right now we're dealing with the common type 1. Every day is new.
So let's, you're having a benefit for her.
Oh yes, May 19th.
Of course, this show goes on and on. I've seen some that have been on for a few years, but if you're watching this before May 19th, this is, of course, 2023.
Yes, yeah.
There's going to be a benefit for your daughter at a place called Nibsy's in Syracuse.
In Syracuse, yes.
And they're going to raise money for...
Oh, this is the exciting part. Yes, we're raising money for a service dog. I call it like a medical alert dog. So essentially, it's going to be trained. The dog's name is Barkley, and it's going to be trained.
Barkley, what a unique name.
Yeah. It's going to be trained to read my daughter's highs and lows with her blood sugar.
The dog, of course, doesn't read. He's
right. It's
air.
Kind of sensing, and it's through the power of the matrix. No. That we will be sending. Essentially, it's kind of what it is. You send a high-low sample. It's a saliva sample, and it depends on what range the number is in. So it's labeled, and then that dog will be trained to read and monitor their companion.
And this dog can actually sense this quicker than machinery.
Right. So that's the point. It's up to an hour before a pump or a CGM, which is a continuous glucose monitor, which is worn on the arms. It depends on the individual, but usually on the arms or whatever, that is constantly monitoring. They can read, this service animal will be able to read this up to an hour, typically, half hour before a really serious
situation. Wow, that's true. I knew dogs were, I've always loved dogs. I knew they were special, but that's pretty amazing.
This is wonderful, And so. It's a top of the line operation. It's very, very cool to. We're getting updates as to how the dog is being trained and some of the process.
So needless to say, this is very expensive. What do they give you the total?
It's right now we're looking at $30,000.
Wow.
That's where we are, and we have about half of it, slightly more than half, and so we're raising money for this at the benefit.
Well, that'll be great. So I would urge people, if you see this in the time allotment before May 19th, please consider that. You can always get a hold of me if you'd like. And we'll have some things out on Facebook about it, and we'll mention it at our gig.
Thank you for having us here, Bob.
May 19th. So, let's get into a song. I think we both agreed that Stevie Wonder is probably one of our greatest American songwriters. And since we're talking about your daughter, I'm sure, who you love dearly, his songs are just so universal, but he wrote a song about, he never says love, does he, in the song? But that's what it's about. He doesn't say that, does he? He's saying, if it's magic.
Interesting. I never realized.
It just came to me, too.
But, he hasn't used the word once.
Yeah, but yeah. That's what the song is about. It's about love, and it's truly amazing song.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, we just learned it. It might be a little rough, but it's not an easy song to play or sing, but we'll do our best. So we're going to do a song about love, a great subject.
Yes.
By Stevie Wonder called If It's Magic.
If it's magic, then why can't it be everlasting? Like the sun that always shines, like the poet's endless rhyme, like the galaxies in time. If it's pleasing, then why can't it be never leaving? Like the day that never fails, like on seashores there are shells, like the time that always tells. It holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills you up without a bite and quenches every thirst. So, if it's special, then with it, why aren't we as careful? Like making sure we dress in style, posing pictures with a smile, keeping danger from a child. It holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills you up without a bite and quenches every thirst. So, if it's magic, why can't we make it everlasting, like the lifetime of the sun? It will leave no heart undone, for there's enough for everyone.
Wonder, one of my favorites, and I'm sure yours also. Beautiful. As a matter of fact, when you were coming up, you're only 1 or 2 years younger than me.
Yep.
Or,
yep, absolutely.
Actually, a slightly different Brother. Generation. What were the first pop tunes? What were the first things you got into? What did you listen to?
Wow.
As a teenager.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, so, well, as a teenager, that's a little different.
How about
when I was first coming up, I remember falling in love with dance. You'd be surprised, but falling in love with dance, falling in love with music, with the movies that were on TV. So, Sound of Music, Grease, and things of that nature.
Yeah.
West Side Story. Those were the musicals that people experienced on, you know, primetime TV.
So the dance thing brought you kind of to the music in a way.
I would say I was always part of the music first, and then I got the urge and the guts to actually dance in front of others, yeah. even just at a party. And yeah. then I realized, wow, that was cool. I was more comfortable performing in the center where I didn't really know too many kids and I was just
right,
battling. Yeah. But when I would actually go to a party and say, these are my friends and I'm going to dance in front of them,
wow, yeah.
that took me a while. Yeah. And I'm more shy than you'd imagine out here or, yeah. you know, nervous because I just want it good for my audience. You know, I do want to perform well.
Well, I'm not a dancer, but I think dancing is like bearing your soul to people. You know?
It really can be. Yeah,
because you're really showing them... Yeah. You know, even more than music, you know, you're just letting go.
There's a surrender and there's a, you know, and, you know, from the outside, people might judge or whatever, but who cares? There is a definite surrender and you have to be in a place of, you have to find your zone or your calling for right. it. So right. it took me a while to learn that.
What kind of dancing, I mean, there's so many forms of dancing. What do you feel you
that I
enjoy
love?
The most? You know?
Oh, gosh. You know, it's funny. I think club dancing is one of those things that you can put on a cool trance tune and dance to it all night and
just
not
kind of
open your eyes ever, free form
yeah,
style.
Right.
But, you know, I love the idea of training to have a ballet number that is very technical. Every beat is accounted for. Every angle, every position is accounted for. That's just a work,
right.
you know, that's a
yeah,
really, that's
right.
a task. But
so it's all been
yeah.
choreographed.
Yes,
very
yes,
strict,
yes, yes.
strict manner.
That's a lot of pressure to get the choreography right and all
right,
that.
Right.
I definitely love to let loose, though, and just dance at a
right.
club. And that's so fun. And,
yeah.
you know, my wife is, you know, also shyer. But, you know, when I'm like, I grab her and dance. It's
oh, really?
Just, I just love it. You know, we dance in the kitchen, man. Just dance in your kitchens,
yeah,
man.
Yeah,
do it.
That's funny. My wife loves dancing and she does Zumba all the time. And I'm not, I did win a twist contest. I think it was about 1962.
Nice. That's a twist.
Just because you didn't have to move your feet. But
right.
My outlook on dancing, having played in so many wedding and party bands, when I'm up there looking down at dancers, I say, I'm never going to look like that fool. Because
you
see some of these guys and, you know, so it made me reinforce my not wanting to dance. So,
you know, it's not a bad thing to actually just, you know, the whole Elaine dance for the Seinfeld Elaine dance. You know, if you feel like you're going to do that, don't worry about it. Just do it because it's you. Just do it, man. Let loose.
I'm not familiar with that, but I'm assuming this girl just
stitch,
went for it.
It's a stitch. Yeah. So. It's a really fun
All right.
thing.
So anyways, our main pursuit is you don't dance much at our gigs because there's actually
I do. Much. I try and do the, you know, man. That's just trying to
loose. One thing impressed me, and I have to say this, that you're dare to do anything. We've done songs out on the gig that we don't even know at the time, which...
Yes.
Adds a certain amount of fun to it. But we met in a certain band, a local band that we were both part of for a short time. And what happened is I said, Luis, did you ever sing any jazz tunes? And you said, well, I know Moody's Mood for Love. I said, oh, my God, Moody's Mood for Love. That's like going, you know, that's going to the top of the roster. And let me explain a little bit about this for people who don't know this. So there was this great jazz saxophone player. His name was James Moody. And in 1939, to get away from racial oppression here, he was a black man, he moved to Sweden. And in 1949, he recorded a standard, which is still a standard today, called I'm in the Mood for Love. Well, he did a solo, as in jazz, a very impromptu solo. And it was so unique, even though it happened right on the spur of the moment, that a great singer by the name of Eddie Jefferson, in 1952, I believe, took this solo and put words to it. They called it in jazz, they call it vocalese. I don't know if you knew that, when they take a solo. But anyways, when you told me you knew Moody's Mood for Love, I said, oh my God, that's a hard tune. As a matter of fact, I want to ask you, I don't remember you telling me, how did you even come upon it?
Oh gosh, the funny thing about this song is because I lived in Queens, Bronx, and you know, for so many years that back in the day there was a radio station called WBLS. It's kind of the equivalent to 107, that high up on the dial. It was one of the last stations.
Right.
And the announcer, the DJ then, would always, now this is back when the show would go not live at midnight, you know, or right. whatever. He'd right. go out after his show. It was all like a taped show.
Right.
Well, right when he would do his call, his last call for a song, this is, he would say a prayer. He would say this cool, smooth thing with his disc jockey voice. And then he would play this.
The song, and it caught your attention.
And it was always, it's, everyone from New York knows this. Like,
really?
Wow. Yeah,
well,
I remember.
It has been done by Amy Winehouse. She did a version. She kind of put a, like a hip-hop beat to it. But again, this is a sax solo from 1949 that a guy took and put words to. And we're going to do it right now. It's called Moody's Mood for Love. And it's a little play on the song, I'm in the Mood for Love. So.
There I go, there I go, there I go, there I go. Pretty baby, you are the soul that saps my control. Such a funny thing, but every time you're near me, I never can behave. You give me that smile and then I'm wrapped up in your magic. There's music all around me, crazy music, music that keeps calling me so very close to you, turns me your slave. Come and do with me any little thing you want to, anything, baby, just let me get next to you. Am I insane or do I really see heaven in your eyes? Bright as all the stars up above you and the clear blue skies. How I worry about you, just can't live my life without you, baby, come near. Don't have no fear, oh, is there a wonder why I'm really feeling in the mood for love? So tell me why, stop to think about the weather, my dear. This little dream might fade away. There I go, talking out of my head again. Oh, baby, won't you come and put our two hearts together? That will make me strong and brave. Ooh, when we are one, I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid. If there's a cloud up above us, go on and let it rain. I'm sure our love together will endure a hurricane. Oh, my baby, won't you let me love you and give me relief from this awful misery? Na da 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 da. Oh, baby, you make me feel so good. Let me take you by the hand. Come, let us visit out there in our new promised land. Maybe then we can find a good place to use a loving state of mind. I'm so tired of living without you, never knowing what love's about. Hey, Bobby, you can come in and you can play, man, if you want to. We're through.
Okay. And there it is. Moody's Mood for Love.
Thanks, yeah.
So you've been listening to my wonderful musical companion today, Luis Molina.
Thank you for having me, Bob. Thank you.
We perform throughout the Auburn area, and hopefully we'll expand. We may even get into Marcellus or Camillus eventually. Who knows?
Oh, so this is going, this is, today is the 7th. So the story of this came out in April the 6th paper. So that's kind of cool of this, that the whole benefit and all
right.
that.
Right, yeah, it kind of comes together. But anyways, look for us out and about in the central New York area. We're going to be performing at a number of different places. In fact, tomorrow night we're at a place that really supports live music. I'd like to mention the Next Chapter Brew Pub.
Yes.
They definitely are good supporters of live music, so please come over and check their place out. That is right across the street from Auburn Public Theater, Next Chapter Brew Pub, to a great couple that, like I said, they support live music regularly of all different kinds. We will be there a number of times. So anyways, we're going to go out with a little blues tune that I think it's actually one of the original Robert Johnson things from the...
Oh, yeah.
I believe it goes back to the late 20s even, but a standard in the blues field. And we're going to do it right now.
Oh, yeah. Great.
Come on, baby, don't you want to go? Come on, baby, don't you want to go back to that same old place, sweet home Chicago? Come on, baby, don't you want to go? Oh, hidey, hey, yeah, baby, don't you want to go back to that same old place, sweet home Chicago? Well, one and one is two, six and two is eight. Come on, Bobby, don't you make me late. Hidey, hey, yeah, baby, don't you wanna go back to that same old place, sweet home Chicago? Is nine, 99 is 18. Come on, baby, can you see what I mean? Hidey, hey, yeah, oh, baby, don't you wanna go back to that same old place, sweet home Chicago?